Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I got three different monitors for the earthquakes and the volcanic activity that's going on there in Hawaii. The first monitor on the left is ALEP, and I'm going to zoom out and show you the location of that monitor. Okay, here we got cinder cone. I have a monitor there. And this is Mauna Loa. That's this monitor right here. The one in the center, BYL, that's Brian's Ledge. And that would be for the crater for Halema'uma'u. And that's it right there. Okay, and we'll bring it out. There is magma or lava. The lava there in the crater has been rising, and it looks like the last couple days it's had an influx of a lot of magma coming in. That's the center monitor. That's this one right here, and the monitor on the right, CPKD, that is what's called Cone Peak, and we'll bring it out and then go over to that location, which is right here along this rift zone for Mauna Loa. The earthquakes today that are being reported here at Mauna Loa, I mapped them out. They're really shallow. Here on USGS going back about a month, there's been 1,140 earthquakes. Now there was a magnitude 4.1, I believe it was. On the 18th of this month, east of Palahala, that started the most recent earthquake swarm. Now, at that time, the earthquakes were really deep, meaning that the magma was coming up from the plume, very deep under the ground. Here it says 25 to 40 kilometers, 15 to 25 miles in depth. But here you can see there was a 1.9, only 1.3 kilometers in depth. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. So we'll go to that location. And here you can see that is Halema'uma'u. Now, that's the newest one right there. I don't have it posted. I'll put it there real quick. That is my center monitor. You can see all these are shallow. All very shallow. We also have Kilauea here. We got the Halema'uma'u crater and the Kilauea crater. Let me zoom in a little bit more so you can see it. Now, when this picture was taken, this was when on Google Earth, when they still had the water forming at the bottom, but that is now gone and it's filling up with magma or lava. So going back to my swarm program, this is the time frame of that earthquake. All these earthquakes right here have not been reported as of yet. Here you can see 18:15, and then before that 14:13. So we have 5 hours of earthquakes that are not being reported. And let me go back to the spectrogram. And that one doesn't even really show up on the monitors that I have, and it would be buried here at Kilauea, Halema'uma'u, crater. I wouldn't be able to find it, but yeah, I want to go here. This is the most recent activity. Let me make this bigger. I just don't know where to start. There's been influx of magma coming in to that crater. And there was an earthquake. I don't know if it's going to show up here, but there was an earthquake before all this started. And this continued for, 4 hours of magma coming into the system. Okay, and this is when I most recently pulled the files, and I'll just jump up here going all the way up to when it started. There was another time Let me show you those earthquakes first. All right, here is Cone Peak. And that is when the magma started coming into the system. To this, the Kilauea and Halema'uma system. All right, 2016 and 30 seconds. Let's go to the signature. And again, this is not being reported yet. They're still behind about 5 hours in reporting these earthquakes. So just before that magma started coming into the system, which was at 2136, we got an earthquake right here. And yeah, how big is that? Look how long it lasted. Well, we'll try and figure it out. That one comes in as a magnitude. Let me bring this. That one comes in as a magnitude 2.94. We got another one here at 2037. That comes in as a magnitude 1.68. This next one comes in as a 1.51. I should go back to the signature. And then the most recent, which is not being reported. Yeah, blobs of magma, volcanic tremors. I'm not going to try and even do that one on this monitor. So this other one, which is CPKD, same thing. I'm not going to try and do it. It's just a constant flow of blobs of magma coming into the system. Now, CPKD is Cone Peak. And that would be that earthquake there, and it shows up on both of this one. This was ALEP at the top. The one in the center is BLY. That's Brian's Ledge. And there's the spectrogram. I'll try and get it for that location during that time of the earthquake for that one. Now, as of August 17th, they said that Kilauea Volcano is not currently erupting. No surface activity has been observed by field crews or in web camera images since May 23rd of this year. Low rates of ground deformation and modest rates of seismicity continue across the volcano. Sulfur dioxide, SO2 emission rates are close to the low levels associated with non-eruptive periods from late 2018. Well, things have definitely changed since their report. And then they got summit observations for Halema'uma. Let me pull this over. Halema'uma and Kilauea caldera in the past week confirmed continued femoral degassing. No changes in the crater floor, etc. Well, that has changed big time. See, back on the 17th again, it was alert level of yellow. It's currently not erupting, they're saying. Halema'uma, lake surface is completely covered with solidified lava crust, and no surface activity has been observed over the past week. Images they have, they're also outdated from the 10th. Well, today's the 20th. Again, from the 10th, the 3rd, July, yeah. All right, they have an image from today. It says 8:20, doesn't show the exact time. A little bit better view, 15:10. I think what's going on, we got an area here and in the center. Boy, I wish I could make that bigger. That is as large as I can make it. All right, thermal image. Yeah, you can see the heat coming up from that one side here. Now, this was as of 15:18, Hawaii time. So that's pretty close to being recent. Right now, it's 3:22 p.m. Hawaii time. This was as of 3:18. You can see the heat along the sides, but mostly down here along this edge. another image as of 3:08 p.m. Central or Hawaii time, excuse me, Hawaii time. Let me bring this over. All right, here's the image of Kilauea Caldera as of 5:20. It's now, well, that would be 3:20. It's now currently 3:24. A recent image of Halema'uma'u. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong. Boy, I'd sure like to see what that looks like at night. See, this image is not being updated. It's still 3:18. And we still have lava coming into the system. This is what's currently showing with the earthquakes. Why are they so far behind in reporting these earthquakes? I mean, they're hours behind. Hours and hours and hours. Hours. Yeah, let me pull this one over. Yeah, 2017. Look at that. Look at the... look at the magma that's coming in. All right, there's that one. 1747. What time was the last one they reported? All right, 1815. So just like USGS, HVO should be called HBS. Yeah, they're not reporting all these. Yeah, it's supposed to be one. Yeah, all earthquakes, everything, all magnitude. And they're not reporting them. Yeah, that's shameful. Absolutely shameful. Anyways, I wanted to get this out to you. Yeah, there is definitely magma coming in, rising up there at Halema'uma, Kilauea, into the system. Let me close this and I can show you the, see where it went pop there. Yeah, several times here. I mean, look at that. Yeah, they're saying that, oh no, there's no lava coming into the caldera there. I mean, it's obvious that it is. And there was another thing that I noticed too. Notice this earthquake signature. Let me bring this over for you. Does that not look a little bit familiar? The popping of the rock at Yellowstone. Does that not look like the same thing? Look at that. Yeah, just the same thing I've been showing you that's been going on at Yellowstone. The popping, the cracking of the rock before the magma started coming in to Halema'uma'u and Kilauea. Unbelievable. Yep. I wouldn't be surprised if it starts gushing up and coming out over the crater walls. I would not be surprised at all. Time will tell. The other thing you have to worry about is these earthquakes creating a slump, a slide, which you guys all know about. You live there. You should all know about that. Yeah, the slide of this area. So these are the shallow ones. That's the activity. And down here is all the other earthquakes that have been occurring and I marked out today. Anyways, yep, if I lived there, I'd say, okay, honey, let's load up the car. I'm going to the other side of the island for a while until everything settles down. Grab the dog, grab the cat, grab the chickens, whatever, you know, livestock you might have, the goats. Yeah, let's go visit grandma and grandpa on the other side of the island. You know, better safe than sorry, right? So, what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Make sure you're still subscribed. YouTube loves to unsubscribe people. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.